Hello, in this episode of Makerbox Mondays, I'm going to have a look at a filament from NinjaTek called EEL Conductive PTU. So it's a flexible filament with some conductive properties. So let's have a look after intro. So this filament is a flexible filament, like I said, and on the label I have some information here. Print temperature should be 220 to 230, room temperature or to 45 on the bed, and speed 15 to 20 millimeters per second, and that's because it's flexible, don't want to push it too hard. And cooling, yes, after layer 2, and use glue stick for bed adhesion. I was using Magico on my pressure printer. But here they say EEL 3D printing filament is NinjaTek's first truly conductive flexible filament. EEL's 355% you just have to read this, I can't say this word, allows elongation allows for prepared movement due to consistent diameter. For repeated movement without tear and cracking, it will produce reliable high quality prints due to consistent diameter. NinjaTek EEL filament is chemical resistant to a variety of materials, and you can find their website on ninjatek.com. But let's have a look at the prints. The first print I did was Sir Lazelot, and that came out pretty nice. It's difficult to see in the black. I didn't have any issues, and you can squeeze it and it's flexible. It's always difficult to see with black material, but it came out pretty nice. There was a little bit of stringing issues, but nothing too serious. It's flexible, and you can pass it around. I then did a benchy, and that had a little bit of issues here in the inside, like some stringing and drooping issues, and the top chimney was a little bit melted, so I guess I was printing a little bit too fast for this material. And you can flex this and it's flexible. Here's my maker coin. With the black filament, it's difficult to to see. It came out pretty nice, and no special issues, and flexes quite a lot. And then I did Mr. Belly, and that was having some issues. I think just because I was printing too fast, the filament was not able to cool down, so it's a little bit banged up. As you can see, it's rather freaky looking, and it bends. So that was my quick look at the NinjaTek EEL conductive TPU. I measured the resistance of a few centimeters of the filament, and maybe it can conduct a little bit of electricity, but it's high resistance in the filament, so you may I didn't do any proper testing with electronics on it, but you could probably turn on a LED with it in some fashion, but I don't know. I didn't do any electronics project with it, with this filament. But this will be it for this episode. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.